Hi, I'm Almira van den Broek, PhD candidate at the Kind Center for Digital Innovation at the Vrije Universiteit Amsterdam. In this video, I'll introduce you to a real-world case on building and using an AI hiring tool at a large international company. Nowadays, AI tools are increasingly introduced in organizations with the promise to improve how we come to know and make decisions. Rather than relying on the judgment and intuition of domain experts, such as radiologists, recruiters, and police officers, these technologies can learn more or less independently from large data sets. We see AI tools also entering the world of HR, and in particular areas such as hiring. AI vendors, such as Pymetrics that you see here, promise to radically change how hiring is done by bringing objectivity, novelty and efficiency. Especially human bias is a large source of concern. We know that judgments about candidates are often made within the first 10 seconds of a job interview, and that we have the tendency to favor people who are similar to us. With AI, the idea is that we extract raw and objective data, and therefore can finally see the true potential of people. As these AI tools rely on algorithms that can detect complex patterns in large datasets, they also promise to discover new knowledge that experts might have missed. A recent development here is the use of video analytics. By analyzing facial expressions, sentiments, and words, these tools try to unlock what people actually think and feel. Finally, by evaluating the potential of hundreds of candidates in the time it would take to only interview one, AI promises huge efficiencies. So it's no surprise that we see these applications increasingly entering organizations. But how do these promises actually play out in practice? We explored this question by studying a large international company that invited an AI vendor to improve their hiring. As you can see here, this AI vendor really tried to offer a more objective, novel, and efficient approach to hiring people. Specifically, they use gamification and video analytics to understand and predict people's performance. Basically, the online games measure different personality traits, cognitive skills, and career values. In turn, the video analysis looks at facial expressions to detect things such as confidence, positivity, and expressiveness. Together, these tools promise to provide a holistic insight into who you are as a person. The company was really excited about this new approach and wanted to use the AI tool to replace the first stage of their hiring process. Basically, whereas before recruiters had manually assessed CVs and video interviews of candidates, now the AI tool would do that for them. The company still had a final human stage where managers made the final hiring decisions. So let's dive into the specific steps that the company had to take to have the tool up and running and the obstacles that they faced along the way. So first, to build the AI tool, the company had to collect a large data set on current employees and their performance. Employees were asked to play a series of games and record videos of themselves. The algorithm could then learn on its own what skills and traits define a good employee and thus are important to select new candidates on. In this way, the company hoped to generate objective insights on their workforce. However, they soon discovered this might be more difficult to achieve in practice. For example, how do you actually define a good employee? Do you look at volume sold, a 10-year period, or actually performance reviews? As no universal standards exist for this in organizations, defining indicators became a necessary subjective exercise. Similarly, the company discovered that the promise of novelty might be more difficult to achieve. After training an algorithm on the dataset and evaluating its insights, the company was not completely satisfied with the results. While the algorithm revealed new skills and traits that were important for success but unforeseen by the company, such as being introverted, its insights remained limited to the data it was trained on. For example, the algorithm showed that good employees did not find work security and work-life balance important, suggesting that new candidates should be rejected if they cared about their work environment. Although reflecting the current state of affairs, the company felt that such an insight should not inform future action, as it misaligned with their vision and moral values. With help of recruitment experts, the model was updated to reflect not only the past, but also a future vision. Finally, the model was used to assess and predict the potential of new candidates. While the company hoped to realize large efficiencies with the AI tool, they soon realized this would be hard to achieve if managers disliked the candidates that the algorithm had selected for them. It turned out that managers rejected the majority of the candidates, and especially the ones with extreme high algorithmic scores. Apparently, the algorithm had ignored various criteria that were important for managers to hire someone, and therefore was wasting their precious time. This made the company realize that if they wanted to make the AI tool work, they would have to understand what was important for their managers and include this in the tool, moving further away from the ideal of just learning from data. So are AI's promises of objectivity, novelty, and efficiency realistic? The hiring case shows that when building AI tools for the real world and real-world organizations, we might have been too optimistic. Rather than learning independently from data, companies have to prepare for various obstacles in AI development and use, and actually need close involvement of domain experts to overcome those. It becomes therefore crucial to set up collaboration between experts and developers so that an AI tool can be created that actually works for the organization. To learn more about our in-depth research on AI, visit the KIND Center's website or get in touch. We hope you enjoyed the session.